We don't just learn algorithms with data structures. We also use them to solve problems, such as in artificial intelligence. In previous videos, we've shown data structures like queues and stacks. Now it's time to use them when we implement algorithms for graph traversal. The initial algorithms to learn are the breadth-first search and the depth-first search. Here, the first of two videos, we look at the breadth-first search algorithm. Here we have a tree. We have 7 elements. Now, when we look for these elements, there are different paths that we can take. We start off at the root node, which we can see has the element 1. Now, with breadth-first search, we look at each level in order. So let's start off with the root node, which we see here has 1 at level 0. The next level, level 1, we've got 2, then 3. Then finally, level 2, we've got 4, 5, 7, and 8. Again, a new tree. Level 0, we've got 1. Level 1, we've got 2, 4, then 5. Finally, level 2, we've got 3, 7, and 8. So we can traverse a tree by using breadth first search. Breadth first, meaning we go down a level and then in order we choose the elements. So at each level we get those elements first before we go down to the next level. That's quite straightforward. We can also use the breadth first search for graphs. Now this one's a bit more complicated, but we can use the same principle. Let's have a look. We have level 0, our root node. Now 1 goes to 2, 5 and 3. So that's our level 1. Now 2 goes to 4 and 7, as you can see. 5 also goes to 7, but we don't repeat the element. And 3 goes to 6. So level 2 is going to be 4, 7 and 6 in that order. Now 4 was first, so that's going to go to 8. Then we've got 7 goes to 10 and 6 goes to 9. So the final level, we have 8, 10 and 9. So you can see here that we go down the levels and then the numbers in order. Let's set you a task to see if you understand that. Here's a tree. What is the order of the elements with a breadth first search? Have a look at this tree. Should be quite straightforward. And write down, you might need to stop the video, write down the order of the numbers you think that the breadth first search will look at in order. Okay, now let's have a look at an example how we implement the breadth first search. So here we have a tree and we want to implement breadth first search with a queue. Here's our queue. So to start off with, we've got our root node 1. So we're going to use a queue, and also we need to make a note of what elements we've seen already. Okay, so let's have a look. So with 1, we've got the children nodes 2, 3, 4 and 5 on the next level. So we put the 2, 3, 4 and 5 into our queue, and then we pop the 1 because we've already visited that. So now at the beginning of our queue is 2. Now 2 has the children 6 and 7. So we put 6 and 7 in, pop our 2. We have 3, we pop our 3, and we have the child node 8. So here, now we have 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 in our queue. We go to 4, we're going to pop 4, and then put 9 in our queue. 5 has no children, so we just pop 5. 6 has no children, so we just pop 6. 7 does have a child, 10. So when we pop 7, we put 10 in our queue. Now we have 8, 9 and 10. None of them have children, so we can take them out of our queue. And now we've visited all of our nodes. You could see that we visited all the nodes in order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. What about the Python code? Well, in this example, we had a tree, and we can represent that tree by using a dictionary with values that are the lists of elements. So for example, the root node 1 has 4 children, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. In our queue, because we take elements from the beginning, we don't use a list, because that means the elements would have to move up one when we pop from the beginning, which is inefficient. But we have a deque, or a deque. It's pronounced deque, or it does look like deque, but that can be imported from collections. So here, we're going to call the function breakfast search. We start off with 1. We give it the tree that we've got the nodes from, and we start at 1. Now the deque, we start at the element 1 in the list. We keep a note of which elements we visited. Now while we've got the queue, we pop from the left and we append the children. So you can see from child and tree node, if the child's not visited, so like for example, we put the root node in at the beginning, visited is ones that we don't want to put in a second time. And children not in queue already, then we append the child. So that way we can, for example, put 2, 3, 4 and 5 in when we look at the root node. Let's look at our code. Now we're using the deque from collections. We've already defined our tree, and we pass our tree and where we start the root node 1 to our function for the breakfast search. Now we use the deque. We start off with the list we've just won in, and remember we want to put in nodes that we visited. So essentially we pop from the left and put that node in places we've already visited. The only other thing we need to do is we need to append the children. So make sure we haven't visited them before and they're not already in the queue, and then just add them to the queue, and that's it. Now to show how it works, we've added in print statement before we change the queue and after. So we're going to pop beginning and then put the children in. So if we run that, you can see the stages of our queue and they match what we've seen in our example. You can see, and at the end we have our order, in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that was the result. And you can see here we put in the output from our code, and we've put in our numbers, our elements, in the example. What about the solution to the task? What order of the elements with a breakfast search? Well, let's have a look. We put 1 in, then we've got 2, 9 and 10. Take 2 out, and that's got children 3 and 4. So 9 comes out, no children. 10 comes out, no children. 3 comes out, no children. 4 has child nodes of 5, 6 and 7. So we pop 4, and now 5 doesn't have. When we pop 5, we have the child element 8 that goes in. And now we've got 6, 7 and 8 that don't have children. So that was our order. So we had 1, 2, 9, 10, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Did you get that correct? 1, 2, 9, 10, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was the answer to the task. There is a great new opportunity for anyone interested in learning about Python or any other areas of computing. In the next year, new courses will be added to the ALPS Academy, and they will be available to you for free. Written by university professors, they will be specifically designed for international students, which means they'll be easy to understand using simple language. They will even be helped to improve your English, if you're interested. How can this help you? Well, leave a comment. Any suggestions you make could be turned into a course. Motivated learners deserve equal access to opportunities. Help us to help you. If you got any information from that video and you liked it, please give it a like, click that thumb, and if you haven't already, please subscribe and click notification to let you know when the next video about depth first search is published.